Main event time here at the Vodafone Arena. It is the final round. 10 3-minute rounds. Jeff Fenech, three-time world champion, should have been four, we say that 17 years on, up against Azuma Nelson, three-time world champion in two different divisions. Jeff Fenech at 44 years of age, Azuma Nelson at 49, both weighing in under the 69 kilos, the height and reach advantage. Once again, to our man, the Marrickville Mauler, Jeff Fenech. And here they come, and first of all, ladies and gentlemen, a full house live here at the Vodafone Arena, wherever you may be watching, around Australia on Fox Sports, pubs and clubs, and Main Event TV on your lounge. It is Main Event time. The bright lights never die for some. And at 49 years young, Azuma Nelson makes his way to centre ring. He debuted in 1979. It was in Ghana, his last fight, July 11, 1998. Almost 10 years ago to the day. He was inducted into the International Boxing Hall of Fame in 2004. What about the scene? It is set. Azuma Nelson, Jeff Fenech, making a dance one more time. Azuma Nelson. Making his way to the ring, singing, dancing, relaxed, composed. He is the professor. He started out as a decorated amateur, and since retirement in 1998, is a national hero in his homeland of Ghana. He proudly walks to the ring, sporting his national colours. The entourage has been here for some time. Pay your respects to a living legend. He is the professor, Azuma Nelson.
Everything will be starting to click into place now. He could do this blindfolded.
You're exactly right.
Ladies and gentlemen, that means we need to bring you the Vodafone, Jeff Fenech.
Here he comes. Born May 28, 1964. Jeff Fenech, at 44, makes the long, sometimes lonely walk, but does so with the master trainer, Johnny Lewis, and Peter Matreski Sr. by his side. His son, Bo, in the background, so too Phil Cropper. The crowd here standing, almost silent and waiting. What do we expect? We expect a war.
This is Jeff's son, Bo, walking into the ring with him.
The face doesn't change. No. The look doesn't change. The eyes, they don't blink. They don't lose focus.
That's with both of these guys.
Azuma Nelson in the ring. Jeff Fenech on his way. Let's take a walk down memory lane. A former three-division world champion. He won the IBF World Bantamweight title, the WBC Super Bantamweight title, the WBC Featherweight title. But it was his quest for the WBC Super Featherweight title that ended in disaster and ended in controversy in Las Vegas, June 28, 1991. Almost 17 years to the day, our man, your man, Jeff Fenwick, center ring. Let's go to Mark Warren.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please respectfully stand for the national anthem of Ghana. Would you please make welcome back to centre ring, Susie Fenwick and the greatest song in the world, Advance Australia Fair.
Australians, all let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is good by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let
we would like to acknowledge the Sports Minister of Victoria, Mr. James Molino, representing the Boxing and Combat Sports of Victoria, Chairman Bernie Palmer, Scott Brower, Robert Hadin, John Doherty, Miss Anika Williams, Dr. Simon Hillman, Secretary Mr. Noel Sharp, Assistant Recorder Dean LaPasse, Timekeeper Damien Membry, Doctor in Attendance Dr. Peter Lewis, Assistants Dr. La and Dr. Mattel. Set down for 10 3-minute rounds, proudly presented by Marks and Sparks. This is the final round. Judges ringside, Andrew Campbell, Anika Williams, Ignatius Mitsilidis. The referee in charge when the bell goes for the first of 10 will be Malcolm Bulmer. Ladies and gentlemen, pound for pound, round by round, for the Park Trent Property Group, and live and exclusive on Fox Sports Australia, and main event, pound for pound, round by round, fight fans, here we go. with a record that reads 46 professional fights with 39 wins, 5 losses, 2 draws and 28 by way of KO. Tonight sporting red trunks with white piping, tipping the scales at an even 69 kilograms. Residing in Accra, Ghana, trained by Joseph Nelson, Kofi Manu and Yuffie Bohan. Ladies and gentlemen, he's Ghana's national treasure. He's the greatest all-African fighter of all time. He's the Hall of Famer. He's the Professor Azuma Nelson. And so we go, and into the red corner we travel. With a pay-for-punch CV that reads this way. 32 fights, 28 wins, 3 losses, 1 infamous draw, 21 by way of KO. Sporting black trunks with gold piping. Weighing in at 68.5 kilograms. Trained by the master trainer, Johnny Lewis. With Joey Mellon, the manager, with Grantley Keyser, Phil Cropper, and Stevie Christodoulou. He is the former IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World. He is the former WBC Featherweight Champion of the World. He is the former WBC Super Featherweight Champion of the World. Fight fans from Fight Dock, Sydney, New South Wales, Australia, the Melbourne.
Azuma, welcome to Center Ring, gentlemen. Wish you both good luck. Good luck, and may the best man win. Shake hands, come on, fighting at the bell.
They have done it twice before. The first one ended controversially in a draw in Las Vegas in 1991. Less than 12 months later, Azuma Nelson, in the upset of the year, TKO in round number 8, victorious over Jeff Fenech. And for the Marrickville Mauler, it was the beginning of the end tonight. One last chance, one final round. 10 rounds coming your way live on Fox Sports, Pubs and Clubs, and Main Event Television. We hope you've enjoyed the night. It is Main Event time. It is go. Nelson, 49 years of age. Fenech at 44. Both lost a ton of weight coming into this one. Fenech in the black and gold. Nelson, the red and white.
There's already been a bit of a change. Normally Jeff would run across the ring and jump on him. Maybe showing a little bit of patience in his age.
Johnny Lewis said he knew Azuma was ready when he went and saw him in the gym, and he said it was frightening. Age may have slowed him up a little bit, but he is still rock hard. Both just a little tentative, that can be fully expected. As far as clear eyes go, Jeff looks amazing, crystal clear, doesn't look daunted by the task, looks very composed. In fact, the same can be said for Nelson.
Rick, Rick! Come on, get a free, come on, Zuma. Get the head up. Okay, box.
A little bit of gamesmanship there.
Yeah, they'll turn your back on me.
Halfway through round number 1. Fenech with the
keep
left
bucking,
hand.
Keep bucking there, keep bucking.
And this will be a very important part of the fight.
This is where Jeff,
wants to fight it. Yeah. And who can carry who? Who can offer someone else to carry their body weight?
That's it. That's where Jeff fought the first fight.
This is where this is Las Vegas. This was 36 minutes. Right. The Las Vegas sunshine.
You see that hook that Zuma just threw then?
Don't hang in there.
Saw Jeff's career come to an end against Philip Holliday in May of 1996 with a second round stoppage.
Watch those heads. Watch those heads. Okay, bring it up. Bring it up. Bring it up.
There's plenty of people, Adam, that say once you've been rattled once, and once you've been rattled big, the chin is never the same.
Yeah, there's also the saying, you live by the sword, you die by the sword.
You got it. 30 seconds, round number one, a tentative start for the boys. Jeff doubling up with the left hand.
Good left hook.
Nice and sharp left two.
And Coleman, another left hook on the way in. Those two punches. You're going to see now, these guys are going to get their ring rust out. Now, they've been out of the ring as long as these guys have.
Go on, hang in there. Go on,
Azuma just stretching and testing that left arm.
You're waiting for him to unleash, and here they go.
Final couple of seconds off the opening round. It's starting to warm. Yeah. It is starting to warm. Let's go into the corner with Johnny Lewis.
That's the order. Round number one for the Parkshead Property Group. The final round. They've picked it up where they left off.
Sounds to signal the start of round number two. Round number one.
Round number two.
Most likely in favour of the three-time world champion, Jeff Fenech. I had it scored a 10-9 round. Unofficially, that is. Just a little busier, a little more dominant.
Give it up, Azuma.
Work down there. Bend your legs.
Fenech into the corner. Nelson, as he has done so many times before, from the back foot, from the ropes, happy to throw.
Okay, bring it up, bring it up. Don't punch, don't punch, don't punch, bring it up. Watch those heads when you're getting close.
I was talking to Johnny Lewis prior to this fight, and it's so much, boxing is so much about the journey. The result and the fight is small compared to the benefits you get out of the journey. And I think Jeff, and I'm sure Zuma also, what they've got out of this journey has been such a benefit to both of them. I mean, and I know for sure they'd love to just show the crowd what they've got here in this fight.
1 minute gone, round number two. Nelson, who was inducted into the International Boxing Hall of Fame in 2004 with a string of high-profile victories. A couple of late losses to some of the legends of the sport. Speak of guys like Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker at his finest, or Jesse James Leha, Gennaro Hernandez.
Both these guys will be so careful not to blow out too early.
Yeah,
when the fight was announced, Azuma asked for a 12-rounder, Jeff asked for an 8-rounder, so they agreed on a 10-rounder. But there's some tactics there, but these guys know they're not going to go out in the first round and blow themselves out. I think there'll be a factor weighing heavily on both of them. They're looking.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right. I think they both would be keeping enough in reserve with enough respect for their opponent to realise that this probably isn't going to end early and I want to have enough in the tank if it does get to those later rounds.
Get your head up. Get your head up. Get your head up. Okay, box.
Jeff has had a ton of corporate support and public support for this quest. A lot of the proceeds too donated by these two men going to charity to support our most prized asset. I speak of kids as things again start to just fire up in the latter stages of the round.
Okay, box.
A short right hand from Fenech, who bullies Azuma Nelson into the corner. in the final seconds of round number two, looking to unload on the former world champion.
End of round number two. Ben Nelson, three. The trilogy.
And you've got to be careful, Professor. You saw that left hook early in the first round. I mean, he has some serious punches in his arsenal. You can't trust him. You don't know what he's got. He'll be sitting back. He's going to come back out with a big punch.
Let's have a look at some of the action from that second round. And whilst things have certainly slowed up a bunch on Azuma Nelson, he is still that ball of muscle, rock hard. And let me tell you, you can feel those punches sitting here at ringside. They aren't thrown with the same piston-like action as they were in 1992.
The final round for Marcel Sparks. This is round number three.
Round number three, 3 of 10. It is the final round. Jeff Fenwick in black, Azuma Nelson in red. Many calling it unofficially the war to settle the score. In series like this, in this sport, there is no such thing as settling. And the rivalry, perhaps the jealousy, will live on for decades. Two great warriors who admit to being well beyond their best, challenging themselves just as much as they're challenging each other, I guess, Adam.
100%. I mean, what these guys are doing, they're doing it for themselves.
Oh.
More so than anything.
You can hear it. Ripping into the body. Oh. And Nelson on the receiving end, because Fenwick is the aggressor here. Going to the body exactly as he did in Las Vegas. Exactly as he did in Las Vegas. Azuma Nelson holding on. How close do you want to get to the action? Two warriors doing their thing. Halfway through round number three. And for anyone that thought this was a hit and tickle, think again.
Watch his head. Watch his head. Okay, break it up.
Look, Jeff leaning on him, pushing the pressure on him.
Step back. Watch your head.
As he's done all his career, this is the way he fights. He stays on him, he puts the pressure. He got caught there by a little short left hand.
He got caught there by Nelson and is walking backwards. A sign of respect, just trying to get a little bit of clarity. Against the ropes. Now all of a sudden the ring general is Azuma Nelson.
Here we go.
Back into the corner. Both men happy here. It is a carbon copy of what they did on June 28, 1991 at the Mirage Hotel and Casino Resort. They were in the corner. Nelson fending for his life. And Jeff throwing them like he had never thrown them before.
Oh. Some singing his punches, Azuma.
It's certainly not the same zip, but there is sting and there is power. And you want to stay away from the Nelson right hand. Once again, final seconds, round number three. And Azuma Nelson is smiling. He's enjoying this.
Don't hang in there.
Bell sounds. It's starting to get serious.
Jeffrey Fenwick, Azuma Nelson, are fully on the classic. Now, on the way out tonight, please pick up your edition of Melbourne Sun, the Hill of Sun. On the way out tonight, for the next night, so please pick up your edition. On the way out tonight, Melbourne Hill of Sun. Thank you.
Feel the replay. replays from the round just gone, round number three, and most of it was fought in close proximity. Adam, the resemblances between that round and Las Vegas, uncanny.
Yeah, didn't they want stand on his chest and Jeff was throwing the punches. Zuma always had the big bang in there, but Jeff stayed there, tenacious as always, and throwing those short punches, those 6-inch punches that do damage.
So good at cutting off the ring and not allowing his opponent any movement out of the corners or from the ropes. And that's why he's called the Mauler. He's a fighter, a very talented boxer, very talented technician. But strip it all back and Jeff Fenech is a fighter.
Well, here's something we haven't seen in any of the two fights. Zuma coming in, stalking. And Jeff going back on the ropes.
Now, I thought the movement for Jeff would be moving off his left foot to his right, trying to avoid that right hand of Azuma Nelson.
Jeff's got to get through these four rounds. He's, you know, it's three or four, five rounds.
Go on, back. Step back.
Step back. Cracking right hand to the temple of Azuma Nelson. Fenech wants him in the corner. Fenech wants him on the ropes.
That's it. Jeff's got to...
Jeff putting all his body weight onto the chest of Azuma Nelson. Looking for the target zone. Fenech using his head effectively. And tagged there by Azuma Nelson.
Okay, bring it up. Come on, do the arms, keep working. Box.
These guys are arm wrestling, they're getting it. They're sizing each other up still. Here comes Jeff.
Fenech with a great right hand.
Okay, bring it up. Okay. Box.
Malcolm Bulner getting very involved here. Yells from the red corner that he is breaking the fighters prematurely.
Keep working. Watch those heads. Come on. Get up.
Jeff's holding the arms and punching.
Bring it up. Don't punch. Okay, box.
And back into exactly the same position. Nelson from the back foot. Fenech head on the chest. Launching himself. Still very wary of Azuma's right hand. That is Nelson's big weapon.
Box.
30 seconds left, round number four. Nelson showing good defensive and evasive skills there. He has still got that powerful right hand. It's one of the more unconventional punches in world boxing, but so many times it has been so effective for the professor. Back to the stools. They will appreciate the 1 minute break. And just repeating.
See, Jeff, that's where he landed that left hook. That's where he's going to stay there, work him down. Double up the punches. And Jeff's showing what he's got there, showing he's a fighter, and he's putting it on the line. Look.
You don't get judges' points for being nice.
You don't win fights by being nice either.
No, you're exactly right. Both of these two great sportsmen, incredible gentlemen, but fighters. And once it's between the ropes, they will do whatever they can, whatever they have to have their hand raised in victory. This is round number five, 5 of 10 in our main event. The final round, live from the Vodafone Arena here in beautiful Melbourne.
Good left hook in there by Jeff.
Take that, Jeffrey! Keep down,
Keep walking now.
The eye's still there for both of them. They're seeing punches still very clearly.
Big
and
punch.
A great left hand from Jeff Fenwick.
Hang in there.
That would have stopped a charging bull, but it didn't stop Azuma Nelson. He continues with his back against the ropes to fight the fight at 49 years of age.
Okay, bring it up, don't punch. Come on, get him free. Come on, Box.
In just a couple of months, Azuma will be blowing out 50 birthday candles at a time in his life where he should be playing with the grandkids and maybe taking up lawn bowls. He's in there standing toe-to-toe with our Hall of Famer. And
give
doing
it, up,
it well.
It up, come on. Don't hang in there. Come on. Go for it.
Big left hook there. That was a loaded punch. Yeah, Jeff's there. Jeff's walking through those, leaning through those. He's pushing them through. They're big punches.
Straight into the
bring it up, don't
abdomen
punch, don't punch,
there.
Bring it up. Step
from
back,
Jeff
step
Fenwick.
Back, step back.
Nice right hand from Jeff. Found the target zone of Azuma. Gain against the ropes. Final 45 seconds, round number five.
Not too low.
This is what Jeff wants. He wants Azuma to be punching with him. No, Jeff's going to back himself in fitness every day. But he needs Azuma to be working with him.
Right, bring it up. Don't punch. Come on, let's get back. Come on.
There's a big difference just to sit back on the ropes and take the shots than it is to try and punch with a guy.
Don't hang in there. Come on, go for it.
A massive difference. Final couple of seconds of round number five.
Don't punch, both of you.
Been a great card so far, and we are halfway home.
Jeff Fenwick was the busiest fighter of all time. He tops his CV, and Fenwick is putting Nelson in a fame box. Two Hall of Famers, those cards halfway.
Little bit of the better stuff, if you like, from round number five. And Adam had followed a very similar pattern to rounds four, three, and two. It was tight. It was uncompromising. It was fearless.
The difference is a lot of guys get in there in the corner and they lean on each other and they don't throw punches. These guys, and the referee's seeing that, their hands are free and they're throwing punches. But they're throwing punches with some... with some serious power.
Oh, Nelson with a short right hand there, right on the chin of Jeff Fenwick. What a way to start round six, the second half of the fight from Azuma Nelson.
Azuma tentatively out of that. You know, it's a trap. You can see him sitting. He's throwing that left to the body. You know, he's waiting for Jeff to start dropping in and protecting himself. He's going to throw that bomb overhand right.
And he's offering Jeff the opportunity of throwing his own right. The left arm is down. He's almost inviting the Marek Vilmore. There you see the big right hand. That is the danger punch for Jeff Fenwick. It is the pivot punch for Azuma Nelson. Here goes Fenwick again, and Nelson just standing and accepting, showing no emotion, no pain. Unleashing a five or six punch combination at the end of it.
That's what Jeff's so good at. He's so good at doubling up the same punch. You don't see much in boxing. You see guys, one, two, and they show left, right. Jeff will double, even triple the same punch.
It's a talent in itself, isn't it? Back out center ring they go. Nelson stalking. Now it is Fenwick, just giving Azuma no time whatsoever. I think you'll find Azuma's starting to get just a little upset at this. He's got that look in the eye. I don't know if he realised Jeff was going to be as full on as what he has been. He should have expected it. We all did.
There was never any doubt.
There is only one gear in Jeff Fenwick, and it is full speed ahead.
Okay, keep rocking. Keep rocking, man.
Oh, a nice uppercut from Azuma Nelson with 45 seconds left. Round number six.
This is what Jeff wants. He wants Azuma punching with him. He wants him wrestling. He wants him on the ropes. He wants him working.
Break! Go back, watch your elbow. Oh, break! Break, I said. Watch your elbow. Box!
Good. Once again, back into that all too familiar position against the ropes. 16 seconds left in round number six.
You can see the technique there. Slipping, putting one head on one side, punch the other hand, tie the other hand up.
Keep rocking. Break, drop on.
Bell sounds, end of round number six.
End of round number six.
Jeff Fenwick proudly wanders around the ring, showing few signs that age is affecting him. To Jeff Fenwick, age is just a number. Take a look at some of the action from the fight, the last round, and Adam, at any reintroduction of action from our referee, Jeff is just not allowing Azuma any opportunity whatsoever to set himself here straight in and so quickly.
That's it, he needs to be. That's Jeff's style, let's face it. He puts on you, puts the pressure and throws as many punches as he can. Mate, he's still doing it, exactly what he's doing. He needs his elbow to punch with him.
If either man can get through 10 rounds of either receiving or giving punishment like this, they are doing very well. Now again, Nelson starts the round with a beautiful right hand, and it caught the attention of Jeff Fenwick. Make no mistake about that.
Don't hang in there. Don't hang in there. Come on, go.
Oh.
Get up, Frank.
Couple of broken ribs for dinner in Melbourne, Australia for Azuma Nelson.
Watch your head.
Azuma threw that punch. He wanted to get out of there. He wanted that punch to finish him.
And Jeff walked straight through it. Disappointing day for Jeff Fenwick and his legion of supporters was at mid-May date in 1986 when he was stopped by Philip Holliday at the Glass House across the road here in Melbourne. It was dreams shattered on that day.
Right back, no punch, step back.
That was his final fight. 12 years, 1 month, 5 days later, he is back into it with one of the all-time greats. Clipping up high.
No punch. Come on. Go free. Box. Break. Step back. Box.
And again, Fenwick straight into action. The tempo has slowed. The pace has slowed here.
Watch your head.
I think both guys are almost happy to get into a position like this, a position to grapple at him and let the referee, Malcolm Bulner, just pull it up.
Azuma wants to free his arms up. He wants to punch big looping punches. Jeff wants him tight.
Well, Fenwick almost walked into the right hand of Azuma Nelson. And here we go again.
That's it, Jeff. Stay on him. Punch.
Jeff thrown with more control. than what Azuma is at this point in time, with a better eye, if you like. Round seven again, it has taken a while to warm up, but the final stages of the round have been enjoyable. They've been entertaining, and again, they have been Jeff Fenwick.
Look at that, both willing.
Don't hang in there, don't hang in there. Back, back, back.
Bell sounds. And two tired old men make their way back to the stools. And I say that with the utmost respect, but Adam, they must be hurting.
Mate, they must be, they must be. These guys are putting everything out there. Those punches that are zooming through then, they had some serious attention to them.
The beauty and the brawn that is big time boxing, as the card girls do their thing. Let's take a look at what transpired in round number seven, and that was the big right hand to start the round from Azuma Nelson. It caught the attention of Jeff Fenwick.
You see Jeff? Yeah, look, he goes, Jesus.
The right hand
remains
the question mark. Fenwick, three-quarter way across the ring.
This is where Jeff has to come home. Stay on him. Watch those big one shots, two shots. I think we've seen now from Azuma. He hasn't got 15, 20 punch flurries, but he's got three, four punches every round, which will and can have potentially put you asleep.
It was this round, round eight in 1992, that Azuma Nelson scored a TKO victory over Jeff Fenwick. Nelson put in a dominant performance on that occasion. Not so here tonight.
Right hands to the body there by Azuma. You know, the first one worked. The second one, Jeff invited him.
We spoke earlier about Floyd Mayweather, Oscar De La Hoya. The eight-figure sums bandied about for the fight of the century, and both walked out without a scratch. Here's two guys that are old enough to be their fathers having a crack here, and both are going to wake up sick, sore, and sorry tomorrow morning.
Neither fighter will leave anything in the ring, they'll be sure.
Halfway through round number eight. Oh, Nelson looking to speedball Jeff Fenwick's nose clean off his face. Reverse headlock by Azuma, just something to hold on to. Timepiece is working and in favour of Jeff Fenwick. All these years on, though, does it erase the memory?
It will. 100% it will. Jeff walks away a winner, 100% it will.
seconds, Nelson reaching as deep down as he's got it, looking for some courage, some more, looking for some fire, looking for some power, looking and asking the question, have I still got it at 49 years of age?
Okay, break it up, break it up, no punch, break it up, watch your head, come on, step back, over the corner, box.
If you ever want to see one man put himself under so much pressure, look at Jeff Fenwick. Can you imagine the pressure he had coming into this fight? His own hometown, his own country, against Azuma Nelson, the guy who annihilated him last time they hopped in the ring, the guy he'd have dreams about this guy. And then he decided to choose this guy, hop back in the ring and face him one more time.
I'm not talking out of school, but Jeff has said privately that he wakes up in the morning still, not every day, but still thinking of Azuma Nelson. That's 17 years ago. Now they've got 6 minutes, maybe, to right some wrongs.
But then for him to go and put it out in front of hundreds of thousands of people yet again, and put it all out up on the line again.
I mean, that's, we go to Blacktown City
put yourself under pressure.
Lawrence Tuaza for the Blacktown head squad. Right now, man group, demolition and strip out. And talking of strip out, what about this lady? The girls from Ed Hardy, they've got two to go.
Getting on in years, getting on in rounds here live from the Vodafone Arena. Jeff Fenwick and Azuma Nelson.
Is the final
part three.
We've got two to go. Round number nine.
A mouth guard in for Fenwick. Johnny Lewis entering the squared circle. And time on is called round number nine, the penultimate round, 6 minutes to go. Jeff Fenwick unofficially ahead on the points card. We think.
I think you're going to forget all the previous rounds. It's down to these last two rounds. Both these guys would have known exactly what's left.
You think these two guys are taking it easy? Think again. It is game on in Melbourne.
These guys know what 6 minutes is. They know how much they've got in the tank. And you watch, they will end this fight with nothing. Not a drop left in the tank.
Fenwick again cornering, trapping Azuma Nelson, just not giving him the opportunity.
Right, bring it up, go punch, come on.
The blue corner, go free. Very parochial behind their man Azuma Nelson.
Box.
In the black trunks, Jeff Fenwick, perhaps, just perhaps, on the edge of redemption, personal redemption. Nelson is still stalking. Fenwick has seen the look in these eyes before.
His legs are back.
Popping out the left hand to Azuma Nelson. The crowd's not enjoying this here at the Vodafone Arena. I wouldn't be like running into the Azuma Nelson right hand either.
I mean, that's class. I mean, if you can stay away from a guy like Azuma Nelson like that, Azuma knows how to cut a ring off. Look at this, it's just footwork. Left, right, back, forward.
45 seconds left in the penultimate round. Nelson looking to trap Fenwick, does so on his left. This is about victory for Jeff. The boos and cheers mean very little. It has eaten him inside for 16, 17 years.
A fighter knows when guy's doing what Jeff's doing now, walking and dictating the fight, not getting hit, that's what a fighter knows. A fighter knows that's class.
Fenwick strikes, so too Nelson.
It's a very small place in that ring. If you can move and you can make that ring look so big, that's a class act.
3 minutes remain. 3 minutes only.
3 minutes. The final round. The final countdown. The third and final bout. The fifth and final round.
Punch it. Don't even get any free shots off, mate. Keep your hands up, mate. Keep it tight. Stay on his chest.
Azuma Nelson, exhausted in his corner. Adam Watt, the hands of Jeff Fenwick.
Yeah, for sure they're gone. I mean, we know Jeff's always had problems with his hands, but he's been punching the body, he's been punching top of Azuma's heads. I mean, there's no doubt Jeff's hands are gone. I mean, and that's what I was saying before, in that last round when he moved like that, Azuma knows his hands are gone.
Yeah.
Azuma knew it, but Azuma still couldn't cut him off. I mean, it's class. 3 minutes,
class.
Mate.
Blood sprinkled over the ringside tables. The two men embrace. after nine rounds in 2008, eight rounds in 1992, and 12 controversial rounds in 1991. The hands of Fenwick, we believe, are gone.
Good, good moving. Look at that moving, by Jeff. I mean, left, right, left, back, forward.
Nelson charging forward, a two-punch combination. And Jeff Fenwick still very wary of exactly what Azuma Nelson has to offer and the power he is able to generate in that right glove.
Can you imagine how many men Azuma Nelson's cut the ring off and put to sleep? You can't do that, this man.
Let's go.
2 minutes remaining in this one. Nelson into Fenwick, now trying to trap the Australian.
Perfect, Jeff. He's going to move. He's his ribs or his hand, whatever it is. He's going to move, keep doing that. You know, he's not going to listen to the crowd or listen to, you know, stand there and fight, because that's what Azuma wants him to do.
He'll have something to say at the end of it. You can be sure about that.
No, this guy's all class. Look at this.
Good body shot from Azuma Nelson, just without the zip he requires. And the two warriors go at it one more time. 90 seconds left and the trilogy is officially over. Counting down the seconds. Nelson again trapped on the ropes. Fenwick, though, more cautious with what we believe are broken hands. He's unable to throw with the abandon he was earlier in the fight.
Well done, Jeff.
Oh, Nelson with a good shot.
Come on, Jeff. Hold him, Jeff.
Fenwick wobbling.
Get in, Jeff. He is.
Fenwick wobbling.
Come on, Jeff. 40 seconds.
40 seconds left. Jeff Fenwick stands his ground and says, let's fight.
Rick, good boy, Jeff. Rick, what he's going to do.
Come on, Rick,
30 seconds to go.
Come on. Get back. Box. Okay, bring it up, bring it up.
The timepiece is counting down. The Warriors have given it their all.
Good left hook there by Jeff.
We hope you've enjoyed a stroll down memory lane. Jeff Fenwick and Azuma Nelson. And from world champion, Jeff Fenwick is now a champion on top of the world.
Well done. I never thought there was a ring guard, but I think there is one now. I mean, that's a great ending. We go to the Rockers scorecard.
Two of the all-time greats, Jeff Fenwick and Azuma Nelson, embraced by his son, Bo.
Fantastic.
The courage, the determination, the pride, the respect. It had it all. The ring is awash of supporters, hangers on if you like. The Fenwick family making their way into the ring.
Come on. I was screaming, but now I lost my voice.
Let's take a look at some of the action from the 12th and final round. A round that had, well, a little bit of everything, let's be honest.
That's it. He got caught in that last round, Jeff. He really did.
There were some nervous moments.
Yep.
Azuma Nelson, as brave and as tough as he was in 1991. Isn't it wonderful? We are waiting for the judges' scores to come in. Jeff Fenwick has waited 17 years for this. You know one. The judges scored 114-114. 115-113 Fennec. 116-112 Nelson. That was 1991. That was the rort. Even the pro Nelson fans can see Jeff Fennec won by 3, 4, or 5 points. Let's go to Mark Warren.
Thank you, Andy. We go to the judges' scorecards, but first of all, from so many people from the world of boxing, please put your hands together for two champions of the boxing ring, not today, not yesterday, of all time. We go to the judges' scorecards. Andrew Campbell scores the fight. 96-94. Miss Anika Williams scores the fight. 96-94. Mr. Ignatius Misalidas scores the fight. 95-95. A draw. The winner by majority decision and out of the red corner, Jeffrey Fennec!
Yes. The smile on the face, it's back on Jeff Fennec. Azuma Nelson is smiling too. What a performance at 44 years young. Let's go to Mark.
Jeffrey Fennec, they have come in numbers to Vodafone Arena here in Melbourne. They are just tremendous fight fans. We now have a draw with this great man. We now have the victory avenged from Princes Park. My goodness gracious, you've turned back the clock.
You know, first to all the people, thank you very much. To Azuma Nelson, you know, I told you that he wouldn't get tired. For everybody else, I know it wasn't the old Jeff Fennec, but hopefully he was a little bit smarter. As everybody knows, I think somebody wrote in the paper this week that your chin don't get any better as you get older, and I just had to make sure that I protected it as much as I could. And Azuma Nelson's still got that magic punch. He's still a great, great warrior, and I'm just so honoured to have a little win against him tonight. Azuma, thank you very, very much.
I'm going to Azuma right now. One final question. We've got to ask it. You danced for the last two rounds. Are the hands shot to pieces?
No, I don't know about the hands, but I think somebody told him I had a bad rib, and hit me in the rib quite a few times, and after about the third round, it was a little bit hard to breathe, but I just did what I had to do to win the fight.
Azuma, 10 rounds of boxing at 49 years of age, the first time ever the two Hall of Famers have fought after being inducted. You are a true legend. You came to Melbourne, destroyed his soul in 1992. Tonight, he gets the nod. After that infamous draw in Vegas, how'd you pull up, champ?
Well, it's okay. I'm happy for the fight, you know, and I know there's no way I can go to the distance and to win the fight, you know, and when he start running away, you know, I decided to knock him out when he start running away, and you know, the fight's supposed to be draw, but you know, it's in this country, what happened.
You think it should have been a draw?
Definitely, you know, because this, you know, I'm into fight. You know, he knows that when I snatch his turn, I will.
But he had to take a draw in Vegas. We're not going to get into this now. Two Hall of Famers in the sunset of their careers, the third time. There'll be no number four, for God's sake.
No number four, because I make him happy. You know, so far as he's happy, I'm happy.
We'll go back to Andy Raymond at ringside.
Yeah, no number four. Three is just about enough. One to Fennec, one to Nelson, and a controversial draw.
Fantastic.
Two Hall of Famers, that surely brings down the curtain on these two fabulous careers. Plenty more boxing coming your way live around Australia. Big time boxing this Friday night. IBO middleweight title, Daniel Gill in a defence live, 7:30 Eastern on Fox Sports 2. It's from the Campbelltown Catholic Club. This Friday, join us ringside. Quite a night put on by the Grange Old School Boxing Crew. Plenty coming your way for you international fans, because on Main Event and Fox Sports venues, the world lightweight title, David Diaz and the Pac-Man Manny Pacquiao live Sunday, June 29, 11 a.m. Eastern, also 11 a.m. Eastern, live Sunday, July 27th. The battle of the welterweight superpowers, even more important now with the retirement of Pretty Boy Floyd. It is Mikel Cotto and Antonio Marighetto. That's what's coming up on Main Event and Fox Sports venues. What a night it has been. It has been a walk down memory lane. If you like, we've wound back the clock. In 1991, it was a draw. In 1992, it was Azuma Nelson's hand raised in victory. Tonight, our very own three-time world champion and Hall of Famer, Jeff Fenech, finally got the nod. On behalf of Mark Warren and Adam Watt, I'm Andy Raymond. It's been our pleasure. We look forward to your company next time we're ringside on Big Time Boxing.
Sports production. It made headlines around the world. Jeff Fenech drew on points in what experts believe was his fight.
And Fenech continues to be the aggressor.
I thought that Jeff won comfortably. We know he won that fight.
The rematch was clear cut, and Azuma Nelson kept the title.
Down goes Fenech for the third time of the fight.
17 years on, Fenech's determined to avenge the draw.
Let's do it again. I'm coming here to knock him up.
Fenech v. Nelson. The final round. Encore tomorrow, every 4 hours from 6 a.m. on Main Event. Order now. David Diaz, the lightweight southpaw, disposed Eric Morales to take his world title. Manny Pacquiao, 4 world titles in 4 different weight divisions. Now he wants Diaz's title to make it 5-5. But Manny Pacquiao doesn't like facing southpaws. 2 of today's most aggressive boxers in a fight for history, a fight for destiny. Diaz v. Pacquiao, live Sunday, June 29 at 11 a.m. on Main Event pay-per-view. The U.S.-based IBF Super Flyweight Champion has something Vic Darchinian wants. The world title belt. Ozzie Vic ruled the flyweight division for several years, and now he's stepped up in weight to dominate the Super Flyweight division.
Vic wants to bang, bang, bang every shot.
Kirillov hasn't had the title for long, and as if Vic didn't hit hard enough at flyweight. Kirillov v. Darchinian. Live Sunday, August 3 at 11 a.m. on Main Event.
WWE presents Night of Champions, where every championship is defended. It's a night of defenders. It's a night of challengers. It's a night of champions.
WWE Night of Champions, live Monday, June 30 at 10 a.m. on Main Event. UFC light heavyweight champion Quentin Rampage Jackson is putting his belt on the line against the man who beat legendary Americio Hua, UFC superstar Forrest Griffin, the original Ultimate Fighter. Plus, hard-hitting middleweights Patrick Cote and Ricardo Almeida battle for a title shot. The Ultimate Fighting Championship presents UFC 86 Jackson v. Griffin, live Sunday, July 6 from 12 noon on Main Event pay-per-view. Men enter. Only one will survive. Live from Tokyo on July 7th, the K-1 World Max Final 8. Masato, Buakaw, Sauer, Zambides, and more. Who is pound for pound the best fighter on the planet? Every electrifying fight, every great knockout. Live for the first time ever. The K-1 World Max Final 8. Monday, July 7th at 7 p.m. on Main Event.
With Floyd Mayweather Jr. retiring, the stage is set for the biggest showdown in the welterweight division.
Look at Cotto. This kid can fight.
Undefeated WBA champion Miguel Cotto and IBF title holder Antonio Margarito have a history of never backing down.
A strafing attack from Margarito.
On July 27, they'll fight each other.
Oh, man, I can feel that.
Cotto v. Margarito. Live Sunday, July 27 at 11 a.m. on Main Event Pay-Per-View.
I have nothing to lose. I can walk out of this arena, head held high, no matter how this fight goes, just simply by getting in the ring with him.
It's the toughest matchup so far.
What I'm about to go through tonight is one of the hardest moments I've ever had to face in my whole entire life.
Our Aussie Bruce McPhee will face off with the world champion, Thailand's Yodsen Klai.
I'm going to get in there, I'm going to give them all.
Can another Aussie go through?
No step back, no stepping back.
The Contender, Muay Thai, Thursday 8:30 exclusive to Fox 8.
For these two gladiators, the road to victory has been paved with blood and pain. The hometown hero, Booker T, a six-time world heavyweight champion. The Samoan submission machine, Samoa Joe, the reigning champion in TNA. Two warriors, one championship, only one can be victorious. TNA Wrestling presents Victory Road. Live Monday, July 14 at 10 a.m. on Main Event.